So actually, this SCADA, we have seen the comparison between the architectural of SCADA with respect to the individual tools, okay, which has been listed over there. And we have created an at the end of the session, we have created in a screen works for the basic requirement of the SCADA functionality, okay. So today, the third session and the final session, let me teach you how to develop an application, and I will show the around 3:30. I will show some of the small applications which we created for our experimental applications, okay, which we created for in a small academic experimental purpose SCADA screen, which is done as a part of a PLC laboratory, okay. So that will give you some good insights about how the screen should be there and what are the basically the SCADA consists of. We have to create an, for example, the environment we should study properly. So for that, I have opened the screen works. Okay, so I have created an the screen works. Okay, so those screen works are basic screen works I have been presented over here. So one, the screen work is been done. Okay, for example, we have created four different screens, which is in basically required for any engineering domains. Okay, one is related to that graphical user interface, related to that particular process or application or machine or experiments need to be done. The next one is that the alarm screen is very important. Okay, so whatever that the predefined values, which is not in the set value, which is crossing the set value, we need to trigger the alarm with sounds. Okay, then the trending of graph, which I requested to you all of you to discuss about why we students we are requesting them to draw the graph and the tabulation from graph, replicating the data table from to graph and analyzing the graph we have seen. Then the data logger part. So whatever the data, all the data need to be done. For that, we have created in a screen which is called as an electrical machine with some part of symbols. Okay, so it's like this we have created, and just I want to delete few of them unnecessary symbols over there. I want to just check just I created one application. Just for your understanding. So I have created an application within start and stop. Okay, and the one more is emergency stop button. Okay, so wherever you require an text boxes to indicate the purpose of that function, just use the text boxes which is available in the toolbox. Okay, which is normally called as an e-stop. Emergency stop button. So this time typing at the e stop. Okay, so use the property toolbox available in the right hand side. Okay, to so just bring this stop button as in a bigger and type e stop like this. Similarly, just I want to okay start and so I have used these two buttons. So there is a simple induction motor this time placing it. So if you are not able to do certain analysis, for example, this is an I want to check the speed in RPM. Okay, so I need some indicator. What is the RPM is running or I want to indicate what is the voltage and current. Okay, so use this basic shapes, not in basic shapes, you can use some buttons and light switches or in terms of slider gauges. Okay, you can use some meters over there to indicate the like square meters are available. You can use some, or edit box also you can use something like this edit box with some expandometer. You can show it in the engineering unit also by giving some variables. You can give this some engineering values also, engineering unit like dash volt. Okay. You can format these formats and you can change the font size. You can like this. So if you want to, it should be spin box only. I'm reading the data, just you make it this like this. So you can use this kind of toolbox properly to design, customize your application one. Okay, so like this you can put this meter. Okay, like this. Use Control C, Control V to create a label for meter. Like this, there are many meters are available. You just use it, and if you want to vary the parameter value inside the meters, say example, I have only in 0 to 100, so it should be scale settings. You can vary up to 0 to 300. You can vary this 0 to 300. Like this, you can vary the scaling parameter. Like you can scale whatever value you want to change this one, and you can make it like this. You can put this for current, similarly for ampere. Okay, so you can mention this, which ampere, how many ampere is consuming. Once I am started this experiment, this particular motor should will indicate what is the current rating, voltage is being consumed, energy calculations you can do. Like this, you can create a simple applications. Okay, so once it started and stopped, nothing will come. Now we will see how the application look like. Okay. Let me run through this run button. Okay, just run it. Okay, so it will show you evaluation mode. It will run continuously for 2 hours if you are connecting. Okay, so
Participants, please stay online. Professor will join. There is a system reboot problem. He will join shortly. Please wait.
Sir, I'm wishing to just provide me an screen sharing facility.
Yes, sir. Given, sir.
Thank you. Sorry, extremely sorry. The system is gone up. Hope the screen is visible now.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what you have seen in the picture SCADA screen is we have developed and we received with the same scheme. We have created in a small, very small, very very small experimental setup, which the motor is induction motor is there, which I am going to do some load test and all you consider. So I have created an indicator for better understanding. I have created an Edinburgh display and a voltmeter. If required, you put this ammeter and all. These are all required. For it's up to the designer based on the specification of that particular experimental setup or the machine process. You can develop the application within a maximum of the good GUI front end. Okay, so you can use like this also, like in meters are available with the scales. You can maximum you can bring it to 300. Okay, and like this you can make. Okay, so So like this, you can make your visual gatherizations as possible like this. Okay, so you can change the scaling parameter. By changing their okay. So once you complete this one, you just run through it and save the changes and go through the screen how it looks like. Okay, so nothing value will come over here. Meter won't show any data because we are not generated or not connected any data through real time or in simulation mode. Okay, so what you have to do is the next step, it you have to, once you created an like this, you have to create a screen. Then we have created multiple screens. We will come back one by one. We have to create another. Next step is we have to create an variables, okay, which is nothing but normally in PLC we called as an tag or variable or input IO. Normally we called as an PLC IO. Here we called as an real time databases. Okay, so real time databases, we have to create in those variables. Okay, so we have to create those variables and we have to map this variable to the PLC variables. Then only this will work for real time. Okay, first we have to create in a real time database. We have to create in variables. How to create a variables and how to, what are the variable structures are there? We'll see within a small PPT. Okay, so with this PPT, we can also understand the basic functionality. Okay, how me share, start working with this. Go to left hand side, the project resources. In that you will find connecting the real time list communication drivers will be there to connect the PLC. In that there will be list variables will be there. So you have to use this list variable, right click and create a new variable. For example, we are given exercise. So I want to create a start button. So it required one variable. Okay. Next one is I have used stop button. So I have used stop button. So you can give some meaningful name of the particular variable. The variable type I will comment. Then I have used e stop button. I have used two indicator to indicate the, I have used three indicators. One is voltmeter in the box, that is meter type, and I have used edit box also. So I have used voltage to indicate the current of the motor voltage. So I am creating this voltage and I have created current indicator in terms of ampere. So these are all the values I want to check, and I want to know about this. And another one is indicator, which I'm going to create now. Okay, whether it's on or off. Okay, so let it be. So I'm going to create one more basics light indicator to indicate the status of this motor, whether it's on or off. Okay, I let it be present in the in front of the motor. Okay. So once you press start button, it has to show some value and it has to read from the PLC or the sensors what are the voltage and current being presented consumed by the motor. Okay, so I have created a list of variables over here. Okay, so my next job is to the understanding about the data types. Okay, so since you are mixed up group, there are different data type available. Okay, so as you seen, whenever I click, it shows the data type. It's in weird 16 bit. Okay, my so for start and stop, for example, if you want to start the process, if you want to stop the process, what data type should be I have to use? Anyone? If I program the PLC, what data type I will use for the start and start command? Can anyone tell me? Or emergency stop button? What should be my data type for my voltmeter to
bit type, sir?
To measure the voltage. Which one?
Bit type.
Sorry, sir, I can't get you.
Yes. What type of data?
Voice is not clear.
We are using bit type data, sir.
What type of data? Okay. Bit type. Good. So for a voltmeter and ammeter from PLC. So PLC is having connected with some sensor. PLC reads a current value and voltage value. By which I want to measure the. I want to represent here. What data type I have to use?
Variable data, sir.
Either bit type. What data type it should be? Start and stop bit is sufficient, and e stop also sufficient. Since we are using in PLC ladder diagram, will be on and off only. So we'll bit is sufficient for ampere voltage indicating what type I have to use.
Variable, sir.
So variable, it's an
analog type, sir.
Analog type is okay, sir. In analog type, there are several number where analog types are there. What actually the defaultly showing in the SCADA is nothing but 16 bit without word sign. So it's all about the processor capability of the PLC, whether the PLC may be 11 bit, 12 bit, 14 bit, 16 bit, 32 bit, 64 bit. Okay. So analog will rely on the number of bits. So where 16 bit defaultly, when I am creating new tag, it shows that it's all 16 bit word. Actually, it's not an proper way. It's been created with the default data type. Okay. We should not use this data type. Otherwise, if you put start press button through your SCADA, motor won't stop and start. Okay. So we have to understand the what are the data types found in the one. Okay. We will see one by one. So I am clicking this start button. I just want to change the data type over here. Okay. I used a name called variable name called start button. I have used, if you want, you can use description. Just click on the type. Okay. See, 11 different data types you can found in the for the given set of given particular variable. Okay. So here bit is available, signed byte is available, byte without sign is available, signed word 16 bit available, word with without sign also available 16 bit, double word, float, double precision, string. For example, I want to read alphabets, ASCII characters. Okay. So for that, I can use string word. Or sometimes I can use some fixed bit arrays also. Okay, so this is how we will do some mistakes in our one. So you have to be very careful. So you choose bit for the start and stop. Once you change this bit, okay, so just change the bit. Okay. Defaultly, it will come ideally. So you just change each stop button. We want to choose the bit only. So I have to do voltage. You can use a sign word 16 bit in a word bit. Sign word you can use. Okay, you can use if you want to display in floating 32 bit single precision or double precision, if you are using float, that it will show you at 230.5 volt. That I cannot show it in my word, 16 bit word. So use float 32 bit signal precision for displaying the float operations like that. So you have to choose an appropriate data type. For example, float current also you can choose float 32 bit. But like this indicator, I am showing only word. So I am showing only with respect to one. So the data type variable which I have created in the SCADA should be equal to the data type of my PLC tag or variable. So choose proper data type and connect this data type to one. So once I created these six variables I have created, I have to assign to each one of the variable to my indicator. Okay, so what I have to do, I have to press the start button and I have to assign the start button with an execution. What execution should do? Variable on and off. I have to click this one and I have to choose the start button variable to this one. What should be done? When I press the start button, I want to do any execute command, or it should be simply on off, or it should give impulse. Impulse means one pulse will go and it will become normal. That means it will, whenever you press, impulse pulse will come and it will go. Like this also you can execute the commands. Simply if you are using on off, whenever you press it will become on, whenever you again you press it will become off. Execute command means when I press this start button, I want to execute some of these new specific functionality. For example, if I want to even shut down the system, yes, you can shut down the PC also. Like this, system commands are there. System, if I press stop button, emergency stop button, all my application should shut down. Yes, you can do like this. If we want to generate an alarm acknowledgement, if you want to toggle the sound also, it possible. Like this, you can create a command also. Like this, new command add, and you can add the event also. Like this, when I press start button, it should work on 6 o'clock every time. 6 o'clock every time I want to, whenever I start, after 1 hour, it has to be night. Then you can program it to the timer in your PLC. Event will trigger. Okay. Like this, you have to one. Now I am using simply on off commands only. Just put in a start button, assign the stop variable to that one. So this is one way to assign the variable by clicking the start button, stop button, clicking this, assigning the variables to the my SCADA screen. Okay, so then only the values whenever changes, it will get incremented or changes will be reflected. Otherwise, just lock it. For the beginner, I am telling you, this is way you can do. Otherwise, you just, for example, indicator, for example, if you want to shortcutly do it, this variable is, I want to increment current in ampere, just drag and drop. Okay, similarly drag and drop, similarly just drag and drop, similarly you can, okay, data type should be bit only. Okay, so you can just drag and drop. After drag and drop, just check whether it's connected. Yes, you can check through this slider variable is assigned. Okay, voltage variable, gauge slider variable is voltage. Like this. Similarly, you can click this one, your developed combo box. You can check voltage of the motor is been assigned. Like this, shortcuts are available. Okay, so one is clicking this variable, individually connecting. Or after creating this list of variable, just drag and drop. Okay, just drag and drop this variable to my screen. Automatically, you will get this variable will be assigned to my indicator. For example, e-stop, I didn't assign anything. So let me assign now. E-stop, just drag and drop to my variable symbol. Just if you kick, you will get variable is on off is variable. Okay, so now I have created my variables in this screen. So I have connected this experimental setup and I have been ready with the variables, but still this project is not, this application is not completed. Why? Because PLC or anything. Okay, so let me check now whether it's showing some values or not. Okay, let me check. Save all the values, run the program. Now I am in running condition. Okay, so now I am changing start. Stop means it's nothing is indicated. Okay, stop means it's glowing only. Now you can change. Earlier it doesn't show any value. Now it is showing 0.00 ampere, 0.00 volt. Nothing is reflected in one. Okay, now if you want to do, okay, just use this watch symbol in the run mode. You use watch symbol. Okay, so just click on this watch symbol. Use this, bring these variables. Okay, current. So all the values have been, quality is good. Okay, so that means you have chosen the right parameter type, data types. You can see I have created one. How many are in use? It's showing I have used how many times. Okay, for example, if I give some any value, 2.2, if I use 230, manually I have given certain values. Okay, so now you can see the voltage is showing. I am changing this parameter. Okay, I am just given some input manually through my SCADA variable without connecting the PLC. Now it can able to see 2.2 ampere current is been consumed by, now his motor is in running condition. Okay, so once he started, is indicating, is start, it's showing that your voltmeter reading also it's picked up and it's showing 230 volt. Okay, so like that you can use appropriate data type with the float and all. I can able to bring this voltage also. Okay, so like this you have to ensure, like for example, if you want to make an in high precision data, okay, even I can able to show 230.50 volt, 2.2 ampere. Like this you can able to simulate this. So you can push the data through this watch screen. You can able to real timely you can give, or you can double click and you can feed the data also. You can check whether the like this. If you want to make anything, e-stop button, nothing, everything is in good quality, so nothing wrong in the data type. So there is no inappropriate data type we chosen. So the experimental is showing that start condition indicator is glowing, voltmeter showing indicator, and their indicators are going in your indicators. Okay, so like this you can make your, once again, so you can able to see how these things has been done over here. Okay, so this is a simple graphical user interface which we have created. Now let us stop this program. Now this program we have created with some indicator without using any PLC. I have created the one indicator, start, stop and other things, and I have used some indicator to go on. Here the output start and stop are the forcing variable to my PLC. These indicators, ampere and the voltage, are the my indicator from the PLC. You can get, or you can use some special type of module to read the data. Okay, so next step is to, I want to create an alarm screen. Okay, so the next screen, so I have created experimental. Okay, the finally we will see how we can connect the PLC. So next screen, the variables has been created. Next one is, I want to create an alarm for this particular one. Okay, so how do I create an alarm? Okay, so how do I create an alarm? Alarm screen is available, but you have to use the tool called alarm listing. Okay, so there is when default alarms will become like this, analog alarm, digital alarms will be there. Okay, use this digital alarms. Okay, so these are all the samples already available. Okay, so for that alarming handling, it's very divine one. So you just add new alarms. Okay, just add new alarms. For example, motor e-stop pressed. Whenever I am pressing emergency stop button, the alarm should work. Okay, so I have created one e-stop alarm. I am creating this threshold. Whenever it reaches the severity one, when the alarm need to be one, the activation is vehicle to one. Okay, so equal to one, I want to trigger my alarm. So whenever my emergency stop button is being pressed, okay, so the alarm should work. So let me go to the screen. Let me come back to my create the three properly. So the alarm variable I have to connect, which is nothing but your e-stop button. Okay, so alarm threshold I have to give. Okay, so let me check whether its alarm is triggering or not. Just go to alarm threshold is on. Okay, so now it's blinking. I want to know whether this is an alarm instead of threshold. Let me type the threshold as an e-stop threshold. E-stop emergency has been you should not use. I will use e-stop button. So activation value 1 I have given. Just save this value. Okay, so I have created an alarm for each stop button with a threshold value of 1. Whenever the alarm threshold has been high, then it should work. So let me check in the watch window. Each stop button is true. Okay, so each stop button is true. Let me check, change the e-stop values, okay, by pressing this one. So here I am just pressing to false. Now you can check in my screen. This screen is visible. So I am pressing this e-stop button is false. I press this e-stop button, this will become true, correct? So this is false, this is true. When I am pressing this button, it's become true. So let me check this screen. Alarm window, the severity has become on. Now e-stop button is pressed. Okay, so the condition is on. So e-stop is now starting. So if you want to toggle, it started toggling based on the conditions. Okay, so you just press the toggle sound one, and you can acknowledge all. You can just acknowledge means it will not blink again. Once that means you have been authenticated, acknowledged. You have witnessed that the stop button is pressed. Then some critical issue is going on like this. Okay, you can make. Similarly, I am making once again that condition to be. For example, let me check the data variable. Okay. See, now it is heat stop button is been false. Let me take you that once again it is on condition. Let me check the alarm status. Now it is on, now it is blinking. So you can able to see this particular alarm function has been working. Now the students able to correlate whenever these conditions, okay, like this is a small example of digital. Similarly, you can create an alarm also. Whenever voltage exceeds 240 volt AC, okay, I need to trigger a threshold alarm. Yes, you can do like this. For example, for the voltage. Similarly, I'm creating for alarm threshold for a voltage, motor voltage. Okay, so I'm creating an threshold voltage level as a threshold. Okay, so I am just giving above 220 volt. Okay, above 220. If the voltage level is get above 220, let me see whether the alarm is getting triggered or not. Okay, so for that I forgot to link. Okay, the first and foremost step is to create an alarm motor voltage and click the alarm variable also, like motor voltage. Okay, so then only the manual voltage will go to the so now voltage level severity is why. Because the voltage level is 230, I have given 220 voltages. Okay, so let me reduce the voltage by adjusting my parameter. Okay, so suppose if I reduce this voltage to 219. Okay. So, and I am checking once again the alarm parameter. See, the voltage level 40 seconds, it has been showing with the off condition. That means earlier it's crossed more than 40 second 220 volt. Okay, so that is the way you can able to record your voltage level. So understand, the e-stop condition is on, voltage level is increased last one. We've been 230 voltage as shown, but now the voltage level is comes to 219 from my voltage. So what do you understand is the alarm. Okay, the voltage level is last one 40 seconds, it has been crossed more than 220 set value of threshold. Okay, so severity level is now off. Okay, but previously the 40 second it is when you can able to understand like this. 320 8th February 21 320.02 p.m. is my current timing. Similarly, you can able to see the 40 second is previously it crosses my analog value. So this is for digital alarm, this is for analog alarm. So like this, students and faculty can able to develop an application and record the data of the particular one beyond the habitable. Can use this particular screen which is developed with an experimental and alarm. Okay, so this alarm screen, okay, consists of both analog and digital parameter. This reflected in my alarm screen. So we have completed the two functionality. One is screen work we have completed, and alarm also we have been completed. Okay, next one we have to develop. Next application of the same experiments is the databases. Okay, let's see data. Okay, so we come to know now we are able to develop in small experimental graphical user interface HMI, MMI, man machine interface, and we have created alarm for the particular process, both analog and digital. Okay, do you have any specific doubt on this up to this one? If you have any specific doubt, if you are not able to cope up, any questions? Okay, next one we have developed and we have seen both training experimental experiment one we have seen. Next one we have to draw the graph for the collected information. Okay, next one is trending. We have to develop it. Okay, so for trending, okay, so we must connect the particular variables. What are the variables I need to be associated with the graph? I want to mention the what are the x parameter and y parameter, correct? Normally in SCADA and all the industrial application, x axis will be a time parameter and y axis will be with respect to the functions like all the temperature, pressure, whatever may be the quantity which you want to present it. Okay, so for example, I want to take an you can take data analyze. Okay, so you can take this diagram and this is a graph work. Okay, so for that we have to create an databases. Okay, so for that we must know about this graph. Okay, so the defaultly data logger comes with some normal data logger functionality like this. Okay, so delete those things, it create a new data logger. Like you can rename this experiment motor control. So what are the variables? You can, if you want to record the changes, you can record the changes. Okay, so suppose I want to add this new column, means you can add the variables also here like this. So the motor, I want to draw it in my table. Next one, I want to display my current value. Just change the current, connect the current value in ampere. Okay, so once I created this database, okay, so I need to create an database backend supports. Okay, so how do I do is, there are two ways are there. First one is creating a database without storing the data information from my variables created by the SCADA. We cannot display the in your graph or database next to final screen. So I have just created ODBC DSN, database management server. You have to use Microsoft DBase drivers. Okay, star dot db. You have to create in the data logger with a certain name. For example, motor database dot mdb. Like this, you have to create and okay. So whatever database has been created, let me check whether the data has been created. Let me repeat these steps because this is very important. So I want to fetch the information from my variables, correct voltage. I want to present in my graph, but you cannot directly like indicated like in indicators, like what you have done in the like each stop button, stop and the values. Okay, you cannot do even simulated value. So in order to connect with this graph, so you need to create 10 databases. Okay, so I have created right click and I have added a new data logger. I will rename the data logger as an experimental motor. Okay, so I have added these variables, current value, and I have connected the variable which is associated to my current and voltage as an voltage motor variable to my databases. So whatever I am getting from my PLC or anything will be connected through my databases. Okay, so after that I have clicked this one. I went to property ODBC DSN. I have created an databases. Okay, so I have created a databases. After that I have created a table. Okay, let me see whether the table is been created in my one. So I have created an application in my local disk, Movicon SCADA data logger. So now it has been created. Okay, electrical motor database been created. Okay, this table is now created with the time column, local column, user column, voltage and current. Now this table is successfully created in my Microsoft databases successfully. Now if you see, I have created through without opening the Microsoft database DB. It's software. It's a separate software, like how the MSSS like this we have, Word we have, like that. In MSSS, there will be called as an MSSS access, which is nothing but database server, database. Like Excel sheet, there is a separate database will be there. Though database softwares need to be configured with respect to SCADA. So now everything is ready. Let me run this program. Okay. And we have seen today the screen work we have been created. Now let me to a certain extent. Okay, let me change this parameter through my statistical way by adjusting. Let me change some randomly. Okay, the current value, and we'll see whether it's been stored or not. We'll see, like 1.5 ampere. Let me check, change the value from 220 to 190 voltage. So let me change some value manually, 193 voltage, and the current is consumption has become 2.1 ampere. Like this, I'm changing the value and it's reflecting in my screen. Let me check whether it has been reflected in my database. It is not reflecting. Let me check. see in our so we have not showing in your graph, so there is some connection issue. We have to check where it went off. We have to check why it is not showing in the graph. We will check now. Now we let me connect data link. Link is not available. Just click experimental motor data. We connected. Okay, now its graph is ready. How it has been imported? Just run. We can able to see this voltage peaks. Okay, so you can check for both voltage and current is being shown here. Okay, so you can see here because the data is not continuously one. So we can see with respect to 11:31, the database is been updated. Okay, so it's continuously now from certain value to low value. Okay, 119.19. Then current also has been voltage is black color, current is been green color. It shows that up and down, which is because you can see it in hour value, you can see in minute, you can see in the all value also. So it fetches from the databases which I developed especially for this graph purpose. Okay, so once this has been connected, okay, so graph we are able to see. So I can able to demonstrate once again for your better understanding. I have done a screen work. I have created an alarm for this particular experiment. Now I have whatever I have stored in the current and voltage, I want to show it in the graph to my students. So I have developed an application with a database. In a, without database, you cannot store your, because you need an data which need to be stored for every time. Then only the x and y graph will come. So I have created a database called exp.underscore. Just click it. Create an ODBC DSN server based databases with using Microsoft star.mdb databases and create a table. Table is created. Let me check and show you. Without using Microsoft MDB, I have created this entire application through my SCADA. Let me check whether it's been data logger is been connected. Yes, let me see. Now I have used this table for without I am doing any manual entry, automatically whatever the voltage value, see from 219, okay, you can able to see all the values have been stored in my databases. Okay, so by this you can able to demonstrate the application is having reached a certain level of user interfaces. Okay, so like this. For example, if I want to change some value here, let me reflect it in my graph. If I want to change some value 44 like this, if I want to change like more than from 190, for example 232. Okay, now you will see in the graph also at a one instant it is reduced and it is been increased into voltage. So for the like that you can able to see whatever it reflected in from the through the databases. See the voltage level is reduced, current value reduced, voltage value is increased, motor is in on condition, indicator is showing, the graph also showing with some incremental decremental value as per the data showed in my databases. So this is how the SCADA works with the different engineering user interfaces. Okay, so the operator can able to understand, simply seeing the values, numerical values, and monitor. It may change sometimes, it may not be changed, but the changes will happen. Small incremental, decremental can be shown in effectively in trend and graph by clicking all the data. You can able to retrieve from the databases, even in minute and hour data can be able to see. Okay, you can able to value change the value, how it is become varies. You can able to see particular values in what time it reaches the 199, 193, like this. You can able to find the which time you can able to predict the values have been changed. It's like your chart is showing in your stock market. Okay, like that you can able to understand the ups and downs of the graph with the different user interfaces. So this is the third one we are completed. I hope you can we can complete by 4 o'clock the remaining one particular topic. Now we have been connected trend and alarm engineering one experiment we have connected, we have created alarms, we have created graphs. Now we are getting into the next one is called the final screen, which we have left is nothing but data logger. Okay, so I want to show you how we have created data logger screen. So I want to store, display the all the values which is recorded from my database. Okay, so use this advanced shapes, you can able to use, okay, use the you can use data logger or log window, trace db, three things are there, each is having that unique functionality. Okay, so here you can use this log window. Okay, just use this log window. If you want to change the background color also, of course you can change by changing the screen, by double clicking the screen and the background, instead of white you can use some gray color or anything like this. Okay, even for the background of that particular one also you can change. Background colors also. Okay, so it's up to you to design your screen colors. Okay, so I have used gray color and blue color border like this. So I have taken one toolbox which is called a log window. So I have drag and drop. So now I want to show all the data which is stored with respect to this experiment. Okay, so just click this one. Go to this. Now once you double click, you will get a property. Okay, so you just now let me connect this particular one and this one experiment. You can see the all the log details information related to this project. Another one is data logger and the visual. What are the datas which is related to this particular entire experiment? If you want one, just connect this data experiment monitor in the data logger recipe window. Just click it. You will get all the information related to this database. So as you seen from the top one is your recent one. Every five seconds delay, so there is an values has been stored. Okay, suppose if you want put filter. Okay, so filter means you can use appropriate date and time. Okay, like this. If we put this one filter, time period, what are the data has been colder, and you can just put over the print. You can print it in the Excel sheet. Okay, you can filter it by time and you can filter by the data also. So this is how the data logger will reflect your databases connected over the particular experimental data. So, okay, so with this I'm just conveying my messages. With a small demo we can able to create a experimental setup within a small experimental user interfaces, and we have seen how with the alarm is very important for a particular process application. We have seen how the trend is very very important to infer the data. We have seen the data logger, how this data logger is very very important to showcase your data. Whatever the recorded data need to be retrieved and need to be analyzed further. So for that, there are multiple tools are available. One is we called as an we have used, it is called normally data logger recipe window. Okay, so you can use this window to develop and show your application in an effective manner. Okay, so let me give you a small few gimmick works within the 5 to 10 minutes. Suppose I have used the multiple screens. I want to go to one by one screen. Okay, so let me show you how we can able to achieve this one by taking particular buttons. Okay, use some 3D buttons. Okay, now use this toolbox, okay, buttons. Suppose I want to, from this main screen, I want to go to my alarm window, alarm screen. Similarly, I want to go to trend screen. Okay, similarly, I want to go to data window. Okay, so I have created 2-3 buttons. Okay, so use this property and change the font size to bold, and if you want to change the color also. Okay, this button, I want to shift this one instead of changing manually in the screen itself. So for that, how would I do is just click this alarm button and go to execute command. Okay, and click this new command called the screen command. Okay, I repeat this. Click this button, go to property, change it into execute command. When command and release, when I press this button, what should happen? I have to add new command. What should be my command? My command should be screen and open the screen. Which screen? I want to open the alarm window. Okay, press OK, give OK, give apply. Okay, let me check how it works. Control load run. Okay, let me check. If I press this alarm window, it will go to the my alarm screen. Okay, so instead of pressing this demo mode time-lapsed one, putting this one, I want to click by button, it has to go to next screen. Like this, you can create an step-by-step procedure. Once you complete the experiment number of screens, you can create an embedded window screen, which is available in your bottom of your toolbox. Okay. So in the toolbox, advanced shapes, there is a called embedded screen. Once you created an embedded screen commonly, which need to be replicated in your buttons need to be placed over there to jump between one screen to another screen, like this, execute command, add a new command, I want to screen the command, I want to open the trend screen. Okay, so once this give okay. Similarly, I want to open the data bin screen. I want to, whenever I press, use this screen, data logger screen, it should open the data logger screen. Okay, so let me run. Okay, so when I press, it goes to alarm screen. When I come back to my, like this, it goes to trend screen. It shows your ups and downs in your trend. Next one is similarly data window, means I'm able to go to my data window screen. By you can create an application into a complete solution. So similarly, what I have done, not been random mistakes, you have to create in the same button to my other areas also. For example, trend and data window need to be placed in addition to my trend graph screen. Trend graph screen should have trend and data. Instead of that, I can go to, instead of trend, it should not be trend, like, correct? So I have to change that one to my main screen. Okay, so I have to go to training of electrical screen. I have to go to that screen like that. So your experimental, so go to experiment screen like this. I have to type it and I have to share and I have to close. The default screen should be startup screen, should be my training mechanical one, that should be fixed one. Just run, save and run this program. Okay, so whenever I go to trend screen, I will get this. Go to experiment. Okay, whenever I go to window, data window, delving data window. Okay, so like this, you have to create an application in a full-fledged manner. Okay, so that will help you for your connecting this application, creating in your data online storing purpose. Okay, by which you can able to achieve your minimum experimental requirement for your undergraduate or diploma students. Basically, this is can be done by any level of, even school students are doing lab programming. So it is not a big joke that you can develop this kind of exercise for a small exercise for your laboratory purpose. Okay, so of course you can definitely, you can and develop such an applications in your area. Okay, so you can just change this replicate and change. Like this, you have to add the multiple buttons and you have to get connected. Okay, whether you have to check double time whether it has been connected properly, configure this properly and save the changes every time. Okay, so then only you can okay, so like this you have to, you can go to experiment screen and you can change the screens in multiple windows. So these are all the basics about the SCADA screen. Okay, SCADA to be done. Okay, so at this point I would like to, if you have any questions, okay, just you put forth your questions. I am ready to answer your one for a moment. Otherwise let me okay, so these are all the screen works, okay, need to be sir, send the lesson sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, sir. Hope this is informative. This is okay.
Yes, sir. But actually, we have to configure many parameters, it seems, is it not, sir?
Yes, yes, yes. It is not possible through online, sir. That's what I'm telling.
Okay.
Each one is required some minute configuration.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Only parameter. That's if you by hands practice only, it will come in real time, sir. Because of my experience, I'm doing it quickly. Which I am doing it time constraint only. I'm doing it because I want to teach them the four screens mainly. And need to be configured properly with some property tools, that's all. So everything is self-learning also possible, but the maximum extent is we have to teach them in person. So I hope this four screen configuration able to understand how this can be done for the particular simple exercise. For example, if you want to control in motor characteristics, graph is required, tabulation is required, database is required, and user interface, first screen is required, alarm is required whenever voltage increases. That's what I want to convey this message to all. So these are all the fundamentals you need to create. Once you have the software and if these recorded values, recorded videos are available, you just share it with them, sir. Whenever they find time, let them demonstrate what I have done. I have done very slowly only. I have repeated two times for a few things which is very important, like database and all.
Okay.
Just create it and pass it, and you can step by step you can go when you get free time.
Okay, sir.
This is how we can because in online it is not at all possible to provide them in 10% transformation. So just share this recorded video to them, sir. If those who are really interested, let them download the software and let them install. If they have any question, let them call. You can share my number. I will also support them. And they required after pandemic, we will have one hands-on day session. No issues in forthcoming any sessions. Okay, so then will be useful one. So four important tools we have seen. One is the alarm. The major the screen work we have seen alarm screen work, how we have developed the alarm, and we have shown both digital alarms and analog alarms from your PL manually, and we have seen what is the importance of graph and data logger. Okay, now let me share you the final stage of this one. Is called how will I interface with the PLC. Okay, so what is the relation between these variables and the PLC variable? You may have different questions. Okay, so inge or variable la create panniten r l variable create panni ad assign panniten summa na manual la pandren, but how do I connect these variables on? So at this time I never emphasize about this PLC variable. Okay, so for that you need an hardware which required need to be thought with the hands on. Okay, so anyhow, let me give you some basic inputs about how do I do in configuration. Okay, so once I communication drivers, list communication drivers will be there. You just right click it, add a new communication driver. Just add it. You will get different PLCs names, the company names you will see. Like CanOpen, Beckhoff, one of the popular. Okay, GE Phonuk, Hitachi, okay, Mitsubishi PLC, Modbus, Modco controller, anything which is related to panel. Okay, Profibus, Rockwell Automations, Siemens PLC, okay, Schneider Group, SNAD Memory, or even it is having that common any platform which is nothing but driver. If you are not finding any driver, for example, if you are not finding that company, you can add the driver also. That is also possible. For example, let me explain you, this application drivers are already configured in your SCADA. So in order to one, if you're not available, you can configure also. For example, I am taking this Rockwell Automation. So I'm just adding that DF1 protocol is nothing but RS-232, RS-485, which will support RS Logics 500 and one. If I'm using any Ethernet based PLC like SLC 500, MicroLogic, ControlLogic, Compact Logic, you may require Ethernet cable. Okay. So once you configure this one, just click OK. Okay, so for example, Ethernet IP, it will show like this. You can add multi. Okay, so once you given this one, you just right click on this one. Just I'm locking. Right click, add new communication. I have chosen Rockwell Ethernet IP. So now my next step is to general, you leave it, okay, don't change any parameter, go to station, okay. So you may have 10 PLC in your laboratory or 5 PLC in your industry. First one, we have to add the stations, okay. For example, what is the PLC type, whether it's an SLC 500 or Contrologix or PLC 5CS, okay, just leave it. I'm leaving SLC 500 as my Pactologix series, okay. Next one is, don't, if you want to change the station name, you change the station name. For example, I have Micrologix 1400 PLC, means you can give Micrologix 1400, okay, ML version like this, and give your IP address of that. Well, very simple, you need not to worry about this headache. Just give, for example, 192.16.20.21. So this is how my PLC has been configured. Don't change other parameters, let it be, just add it. Then you have to put this communication testing. If you are connected, PLC is being shown over here, then it will show successful. At present, I don't have any PLC in laboratory I have connected, so it should, after polling time is over, it should show the connection is failed. Okay, so it will try for certain seconds. It is called fail because I didn't connect. If you connected, means it will show successful. Then next tab is, after adding the PLC, I have to add the task. This is very important. When I add the task, I have to connect this my PLC variable with my SCADA variable. So let me recap. I have created a variable. Okay. List of variable like current, e-stop, indicator, start button, voltage monitor, which is associated to these experiments, like variable start, stop, e-stop, voltage, indicated voltage, current, okay, 3, 4, 5, 6 variables are there. This has been listed over here. This I want to connect with my PLC tag. Okay, so variable need to be connected. After configuration of station, I ought to add the task. Task means it should be come from your data file of Boolean data file, stack format, Boolean data format from your PLC. Okay, AB addressing means AB Allen Bradley addressing format. For example, I means you can take from B means B3 semicolon 0, 0. Whatever you have written in the ladder logic, just copy and paste the ladder logic task. Okay, and variable you are configured, for example, B3 semicolon 3 is for start button, means just connect the variables. Okay, start button. Okay, so now AB address is, I want to give B3 semicolon 0/0. That means the address of the trunk particular bit, I have given B3 semicolon 0/3 and I have taken as a start button. Just give okay, the task has been added. Once the PLC has been connected successfully, if you are adding this task, okay, so the connection configuration is over, then you have to run this SCADA program. That means you are connecting this start button. Okay, let me show you. It's showing bad because I didn't use this one. For example, other values are showing good. Start button is going on. But if I use this start button in my one, it's showing bad because that it is used in my Allen Bradley. Without using Allen Bradley real-time PLC, Ethernet I have configured, it is not connected. So using data variable is showing bad. If I connected in real-time, then it will be good for us to be connected. If you are in start button, it will be reflected. It will change the PLC ladder diagram parallelly. Okay. So time being, so this is sufficient for you to understand one. Hope you have gone through this PLC with real time. Okay. That is sufficient, more than sufficient to connect, communicate with your communication driver. Once you configure station and task, the task is nothing but an Allen Bradley address of that ladder logic diagram address for the particular bit variable or analog or digital. just copy and paste it, then give the SCADA variable. This means you are connecting the SCADA variable to my PLC variable. That's all. Once you run the PLC parallelly, if you run this one through Ethernet, if you run this SCADA screen properly, parallelly, you will get this experimental output. Whenever I change this start button, means it will start the PLC programming into the start conditions. Okay, like this you can do real-time interface with my PLC. Okay, this is the one which you can deal with your real-time communication drivers. Okay, irrespective of PLC makers and other things, you can do configuration in your PLC hardware devices. Okay, so if you have any specific questions, you just use this recorded video and you can configure it. If time permit, in the next session I will connect one PLC. The lab is not available real time. I can bear with you, and next time I will definitely will show with the real time PLC also, if time permits. So this is more than sufficient for a beginner who can able to understand the environment of SCADA, how we can able to develop in simple applications of SCADA development. Okay, so if you have any specific questions, we can, I am ready to hear from the participants. Any specific inputs? I repeatedly telling you, this is not an easy platform. Within 3 hours or 4.5 hours, you cannot do any thing can be cannot be done. But by practice, if you need a minimum at least 1 week to 10 days continuous training, then we can bring the individuals to certain level. But how do you teach in the laboratory? Imagine we are teaching the same software within 1 week of time to the undergraduate, which can with a limited minimum functionality like this. This is sufficient for any beginner who can able to configure, design and page with a graphically MMI, HMI create panna theriyum, alarm handle panna theriyum, trending, data logging, then hardware communication with the PLC. That is sufficient for any graduate students to understand the basics of SCADA. Okay, so if you have any question, specific question, I'm ready to hear, sir. Sindhil, listen, sir. Now.
Sir, yes, sir.
Yeah.
Participants.
Any overall comment also you can give.
Chandrasekhar available?
Yes, sir.
Indian session every useful
sir. Yes, sir.
நீங்க இதெல்லாம் வர்க் பண்றீங்களா இந்த ஏரியால ஸ்கேடாவுல பண்றது இல்ல?
இல்ல சார், ஸ்கேடா பண்றது இல்லங்க சார். நான் ரிலே லாஜிக் தான் இப்ப பண்ணிட்டு இருக்கேன்
சார். ஓகே ஓகே.
சர்வீஸ் பர்பஸ் எடுப்போம் சார், நம்ம புதுசாக அதுவும் பண்ணுறது இல்லைங்க.
ஓகே ஓகே.
கேரளா இருக்கிற மிஷினில் ஒர்க் பண்ணிட்டு பண்ணுவோம். சாஃப்ட்வேர் ஓரியண்டடாக ஒன்றும் தெரியாது.
ஓகே ஓகே, ரைட். ஸ்பெசிஃபிக் டவுட் எதாவது there is no doubt wind up the session. Thank you Dr. Girvasankar sir for kindly being with us for the entire day and explaining the from basic SCADA, what are the features available and facilities available and advantages, and you have given a complete scope of this SCADA, and I hope that I have shared the link also with the participants. Hope that they will download and work on it. Okay, thank you very much, sir, for
I thank you, sir. I still believe in this young team.
It's a hectic schedule for you. The
yes, sir. The entire engaging one day. It's big. Anyhow, sir, it is a pleasant for them to know, because it's knowledge sharing is the biggest thing which should happen in the community. So,
sure,
whether you've been really involved or not doesn't matter. Plus, I have done my 11th best to share my knowledge on the supervisory control data acquisition, which I learned in industry.
Thank you.
Transfer to my students' community, because this is having a good job opportunity so far.
Definitely.
So, if you have SCADA purchase in your laboratory, definitely I will help them. There is no cost involved. I will definitely help you them for the career perspective. Okay, thank you so much, sir, for conveying my regards to your principal.
Yeah,
thanks for the opportunity. Looking forward to your second phase next time. Thank you, sir.
Definitely. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Bye.
Participants, we will meet tomorrow morning at 9:30 a.m. Thank you.